When it comes to urban planning, going up and outwards isn't the only option. You can also go down. The most impressive historic and ancient cities in the world are the ones that extend into the earth. Some of these cities were used as shelter against harsh weather conditions. Some served as recreation centers, and others were a means to escape from enemy soldiers at times of war. And now we're going to check out one of them. As human beings became more adept at engineering, they were able to dig deeper and construct bigger and better underground structures. Hidden away until 2005, in a village with the same name, the underground city of Tahyaq in the Khomein County in the Markazi Province west of central Iran was built 6 meters below ground.
تهیق در چنین بافت‌های سخت و محکمی که کنگلومرا خونده میشن کنده شدن یعنی انسان‌هایی که این معماری را شکل دادن در بافت کنگلومرایی و به خصوص در بافت نرمی که حد فاصل این کنگلومراها در بالا و پایین قرار می‌گرفتن و لایه‌های مارنی نرمن دست به ایجاد اتاق‌ها و فضاهایی را زدن
Digging such a structure using today's technology would be quite an undertaking. So imagine how the ancestors must have accomplished it all those years ago. Simply emptying the extra earth and stone would have taken ages. A large number of chambers have been dug up so far. Around this wide hall alone, there is evidence of a religious center, a storeroom, living quarters, and a well. One of the most intriguing rooms in Tahyaq is this one, and it was supposedly used as living quarters. What's interesting about it is that it has 2 floors. You see this hole here? This leads to the 2nd floor down below. This place is filled with winding tunnels with rather low-hanging ceilings that have entrances to many different-sized chambers on either side. Since you can't really carbon date stone, no one can pinpoint exactly when this underground city was constructed. But judging by the age of the excavated findings here, Tahyaq has been dated back to the 12th and early 13th centuries. Some of these findings are on display at the Four Seasons Museum of the provincial capital of Arak and include glazed pottery, oil lamps, gold and copper jewelry, and many different objects. All these items show that people lived here for about 150 years, in the Seljuk period and during the time between the transition from the Khwarazmshahi to the Ilkhani period. Walking in these narrow corridors is really difficult and your back starts to hurt after a while. This is one of the main paths used on a daily basis and it leads to one of the entrances that's on top of a very deep well.
در مجموعه تهیق 3 ورودی داریم که 2 ورودیش امروز بازه و یکی از ورودیاش مسدوده یکی از ورودی هایی که دسترسی به این مجموعه از طریق اون امکان پذیر بوده همین ورودیه که امروز در زیر خونه یکی از اهالی قرار گرفته و 2 تا پلکان از او قابل مشاهده است
It's safe to say that they weren't a primitive people So what drove them to live underground under such conditions?
ما طی بررسی‌ها و مطالعاتی که بر روی اشیا کردیم و مردم شناسی که در سطح شهرستان انجام دادیم دو دلیل رو برای شکل‌گیری این مجموعه می‌دونیم ارائه کنیم. اولین دلیل این که ما می‌دونیم که در دوره خوارزمشاهی دقیقاً زمانی که اینجا مورد سکونت قرار می‌گیره منطقه عراق عجم که خومن بخشی از اون بسیار ناامن میشه به واسطه درگیری‌هایی که خوارزمشاهیان با خلفای عباسی داشت. یکی از دلایل رو آوردن این جمعیت می‌دونه همین اختلافات و کشمکش‌های سیاسی و اجتماعی دوره خوارزمشاهی باشه. و اما دلیل دوم که بسیار قابل قبول‌تر از نگاه باستان‌شناسی اینه که اینا فعالیت‌های مذهبی خاصی داشتن که مورد رضایت و مورد قبول حاکمیت نیست و این اساس اینا مجبور میشن به زیر زمین رو بیارن و فعالیت‌های مذهبی و دینی خودشون رو پیگیری کنن.
Keep in mind that only a small percentage of the underground city has been excavated so far. Even so, Tahyaq is only one of the 10 underground cities discovered in Khomein County. And only time will reveal all the many secrets that these underground dwellings are hiding within. This is Gulnar Farnoodi for Iran.